because you're a tulip lover, you're here because you were dragged here?
Well, I'm not with my wife over there. No, I'm here because I...
Come and say hello. What is your wife's name?
Michelle.
Michelle, and yours?
Stephen.
Stephen. Hi, Stephen. My name's Andrew. Hello, Michelle. I was just asking Stephen whether he came here of his own free will, he's interested in tulips, or whether he was dragged here.
So what do you think?
No, we were both interested, so we both came.
All right. What is your interest? Do you actually grow tulips?
No, we don't. We just like the colour.
You just like the colour. Do you paint?
I paint. I like to paint abstract paintings.
Yeah. Do you paint, Michelle?
No.
No.
Yeah, I enjoy colour, so I'd like to look at the flowers. No.
Inspiration, you came
inspiration,
for
inspiration. Exactly.
Are you living in Barrel area?
No, we live in Sydney.
So you came down specifically for this?
Yes, we did.
Yeah. Just for the day?
And we bought a video camera, actually, just so we can take some photographs and bring them all back. And
Yeah. And do you paint professionally?
No, I don't, no.
So this is your hobby?
I work at Sydney Water.
Uh-huh. Do you see any tulips anywhere else?
No, we don't see any tulips anywhere else, do we?
When we went to... We went to Canberra for the floria.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, we went about 2 weeks ago.
Yes.
We saw it there.
So you go to flower shows?
We do.
We do, yes.
You're a flower perv. What else do you use for inspiration?
Life.
Yeah.
Music.
Music. I paint to music. What sort of music?
Dance music.
Dance music? What do you paint to dance music?
you paint crazy pictures to dance music. And it works out really well because the inspiration from the music flows onto the canvas.
And what do you use? What medium?
Usually pastels.
Onto paper?
Onto paper.
Yeah.
Yeah, I like drawing and intricate drawings.
Yes, yes. And what do you do with them?
Well, I usually give them to Mum.
You don't sell them?
No.
You don't hang them up at home?
I hang them up at home. Yeah. I've got plenty of them at home.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Michelle, would you for a moment play art critic for us and give us a review of your husband's work?
Good.
That's right. Economy.
Good,
I like economy.
Yeah, good. Yeah. No,
colourful?
He's a good, yeah.
How big are they? What sort of size?
Oh, he does big, he does small. Yes. You know, it depends on what his mood is.
Right.
Yeah.
Does he ever do anything dark?
Yeah, at times he does.
Yes?
Yeah.
And what does that tell you? Is he in a bad mood?
I don't know. It depends. No, it depends, yeah.
Where are you from?
I'm from India originally.
Where did you meet?
Well, she came over on a holiday. And I saw her and I thought, oh, she's nice.
What do you mean you saw her where?
Her sister used to work with me where I was working. And so I just said, well, I'll take your sister around and show the sights of Sydney. She came out and looked and she saw, she didn't really see the sights of Sydney because I just, how long were you over here for?
I was here only for about 6 months.
Yeah.
And then Steve asked me to marry him. And then we sort of fell in love at first sight, sort of.
Was it? When you first met? What did you think when you first saw him?
Yuck.
No, I don't know. It was different because I didn't think I would really get involved with him first.
Yeah,
and then when I saw him,
But you weren't planning to stay here?
I was not planning at all.
Did you come here looking for a husband?
No, I just came here for a holiday.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Did you think at the time that this is going to complicate your life?
I thought at times, I mean, if I get somebody who really wants to marry me, then I'll stay here. And then Steve asked me, then we fell in love, and then Steve asked me to marry him.
How did he ask you?
Oh, he took me to a show, a stage show.
You can tell all the embarrassing details of the ring?
No. No, he just asked me for a... in a stage show.
I asked her to marry me at the Seymour Cinema, and the very, very next morning, I rang her up and said, no, the engagement's off, I don't want to do with it.
She said
to me, what did you say?
And I said, no, I'm not calling it off.
You said,
you call it off yourself. But it didn't get called off. It was great, and then after 2 months, we got married.
You got cold feet.
Yeah, I got very cold feet.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'd been hurt before.
Yes.
And so I was she's great.
Where did you get married? Where?
We got married in Sydney.
8 years?
Yeah.
A long time.
Yeah.
We got used to each other yet?
Oh, yeah, we have.
Oh, we're very much in love.
Yeah?
Are
you good friends?
Oh, yeah, good friends as well. You have to be.
Okay, let me ask you this. In 8 years you've been married, you must have talked about children at some point. Are there going to be any? Do you want any?
Yeah, we'd love to.
Yes?
Yeah, we're planning. We are waiting.
Yeah. You're waiting?
We're working on it.
Working
waiting
on
for
it.
The stork.
Yeah, we are.
When all this romance happened, and what did your sister and your family say?
They were surprised. They were really surprised. And I said, how did you manage that? I said, well, I don't know, God planned it.
And back in India, your parents were there?
Yeah, my dad was there, yeah.
And did you ring him?
Oh, yeah, he came up for the wedding.
Yeah.
He gave me away in church.
Yeah?
Yeah,
were they pleased with this development?
They were very pleased, yeah.
You didn't have anybody lined up in India?
No, not at all.
What part of India?
I'm from Calcutta.
Right.
Yeah.
So what about your mum?
My mum expired 10 years ago.
I see. So she wasn't around then?
No.
When you phoned, did you phone her dad?
I wrote to my dad. He was here when he met Steve first.
Yes,
yeah.
And he approved?
Yeah, he approved. He did.
Did your family respond positively?
Oh, they've adopted a daughter.
Have they?
Yeah.
When did you introduce Michelle to your people?
I took her up to foster rather nervously one Christmas.
Yeah.
And they
for Christmas.
Yeah, for Christmas and
big risk.
It was a big risk. But they loved her. They fell in love with her the first time they saw her, and she's been adopted as part of the family, so it's great.
You say either and I say either. You say neither and I say neither. Either, neither, neither. Let's call the whole thing off. You like potatoes and I like potatoes. You like tomatoes and I like tomatoes. Potatoes, potatoes, tomatoes, tomatoes. Let's call the whole thing off.
Slow, quick.
Good. I've seen you so often.
Come and talk to us out in the street. You've seen us often.
Oh, yeah.
Yes?
Don't say it.
What is your name? Come and stand over here for a second.
Yeah, all right. Yeah.
What is your name? No, it's not that.
No, Lexus. Well, I only drive one. My name is Barrington. Ted Barrington.
Ted.
Yeah.
Ted. Yeah. I thought Barrington was your nickname or something.
Oh, yeah. That sounds nice.
It's a good name. Yeah,
it's very good name.
What are you doing here today?
Shopping? Bit of shopping, bit
or
of...
Or assistant shopper,
more or less, yeah, the boss is shopping.
Do you know what for? What is she buying?
No, most probably another little hanger or a bit of jewellery.
Right. Were you born here?
No, I was born in the Netherlands.
Netherlands?
Yeah.
But it's done a Netherlands name, or did you change it?
I changed it.
What was it?
Oh, it's a very long story.
Is it?
Yeah, very long story. Too hard to explain. My name was so hard to pronounce, especially being in business, it would be impossible for people, by the time they've written it down, how the spelling was, they still pronounce it wrong.
Yes.
So I said, oh, get it.
Yes.
Get a distinguished name as I had before, so I called it Barrington.
Right. Where did you find it?
Someone in New Zealand, I knew as Lady Brett, I was always looking for another name, my father's first name, Jack, Jackson and all that sort of thing. And then one night she said, no, I've got the very name that suits you, not very common, but very distinctive, Barrington. I said, sounds right, call it Barrington, that's it.
How old were you then?
About 25, I think.
Okay, so you were young enough for it not to cause a major disruption?
Well, no, of course not.
Yeah. And
what's in the name? One day I'll go back to Holland, find myself a bride.
Yeah.
But it didn't go that far because midstream, right on the equator, we were shipwrecked. And there where I met my wife.
You were shipwrecked in what sort of a boat?
Yeah, a boat, exactly.
A big boat.
you call it a boat.
Yeah.
It was the one of the lines. It was the last ship, the last route they were going to take, and shocking trip. The captain committed suicide, and and all those people in panic.
How many people on the boat?
750.
Ooh.
And big panics and all that sort of thing. So it was completely burned out. So we floated there on the equator for about 4 or 5 days, until finally a tugboat from Panama came along.
Yeah.
And the tugboat was not bigger than we use in Holland in the canals.
Yeah.
So I thought, this is not going to work, right? So we were towing there for one day, everybody hooray, here we go. And all of a sudden, I felt we were not going. A ship, although you can feel very little, I thought, we're not going. And to right, of course, the tugboat broke down as well.
Yeah.
So here, the big tub and a little tub, just floating in the ocean, doing nothing. And it took another 3 or 4 days before a empty cargo ship from Vietnam, from the Laux company, towed us to Panama.
Did everybody survive?
Oh, everybody, yeah.
Yeah. And how did you strike up the relationship with
we met one another, sort of thing, and we had to walk up the beach in Tahiti, and it started to rain, and she had a dress on.
Now, wait a second, we were in a shipwreck a second ago.
But I mean, you asked me how I met her.
Yes.
You know, sort of thing, and it started raining, but her dress started to run. Right? And all purple and bluish colored all over her arms and legs. And he said, I've got a tropical disease. Nothing else. So quick to the ship, she had to shower, and of course it was only dye. And that's how we got along. And then when the ship was really going, we became very close.
Oh, I see. Yeah. I see. So this was as you went past Tahiti?
Yeah, outside Tahiti, actually.
So, in fact, just before the ship, did the fire start on the boat?
Yes, in the engine room.
What is your wife's name?
Ria.
Ria.
Yeah.
That's a Dutch name?
Dutch name,
yeah.
As well,
so
yeah.
She was actually...
Oh, Dutch as well, yeah.
So you didn't have to go back?
No, we just met up aboard ship.
You still find yourself a nice Dutch girl?
No, right.
Yeah. Cornered in there, haven't I? Anything good on the market?
Yes, there's some magnificent places. Glorious, as a matter of fact.
What sort of place would appeal to you out of this lot, say? Is there anything? Like Baradu?
That,
a good
that
name.
Looks nice. I don't know about, but look at that with the beautiful dam and the trees.
Uh-huh.
And somewhere to put the horses and the dogs. And
which you've got?
Yes.
How many of each?
Two horses, one dog.
Two horses, one dog. So you must already live in a...
Yes, we do.
Bit of space?
Yep, we sure do.
You don't grow your
own flowers. We don't grow our own flowers. Not these, anyway.
What are the horses' names?
Oh, God, this is going to be fascinating. Boy George and AJ.
AJ.
Mm.
AJ?
Mm-hmm. And the dog's called Bonza. And he's a border collie.
Mm-hmm.
And he's magnificent, and he's in the car dying of heat at the moment.
I shouldn't think so. It's freezing out there.
Dehydrating.
Do you do any work at all, or are you rich and...
No.
Oh yeah, right.
What do you do?
We have a couple of restaurants in Sydney.
We're living down.
This
here.
Is your escape house.
Yes, yeah. Yes.
Can I ask you a really personal question about the restaurants and this? Did the restaurants buy you this? Is that what you work for?
No. Not at all.
You got lucky on the horses.
They're retired.
They're retired. These horses used to race?
No.
Oh,
only joking.
God, no. Hell no.
So. You're enjoying the lifestyle?
Absolutely.
How hard do you work in the city during the week?
Bloody hard.
I've spent quite a long time with New Zealand.
Doing?
As in the advertising sales.
Selling.
Yeah.
Selling. That's where you made your money.
Tell me.
No, I don't know about that either.
Is restaurateuring, is that, would you recommend it to your children if you had?
Not necessarily, no.
No, I wouldn't recommend it to anyone, no.
What, too hard?
Oh, it's a bugger of a life.
Yeah? Too hard?
Very, it's long, hard, exhausting, physically, mentally, but it's good fun. Yeah.
But it's good fun.
Yeah.
You still do it.
Still do it.
It's good when you stop.
Yes, that's right. And then we had the, okay, now, there must be some far more fascinating people than us around.
Do you think what would be fascinating?
I'm dying for the next one round in the next one.
Morning, sir. Are you looking to buy or rent?
Buy.
To buy. Farm or house?
Just a farm or whatever.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Anything here take your fancy?
We're looking for, you know, acreage.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Where are you from?
Philippines.
You both from the Philippines?
Yeah.
Yeah. Did you come here as migrants?
Yeah, migrants, yeah.
How long ago?
22 years ago.
Is that all?
That's all, yeah. Not much.
You've liked it enough to stay.
Sorry?
You've liked it enough to stay.
Oh, yeah, that's right, yeah.
Well, we had a chance to get away and go to America, came back and...
Did you?
Middle, you know, like decided to stay here.
Do you ever go back to the Philippines?
Yeah.
To visit
your holiday?
Yeah?
Yeah. We still have family. My parents got properties.
Yeah.
In the Philippines.
You said you had a chance to live in America. How did that come about?
I applied as a, registered nurse.
Yeah.
Over there 17 years ago.
Uh-huh.
And in the meantime, I got an approval to come here. You know, like I applied here at the same time.
Yes.
And within a year, I got the approval here. So, and in the meantime, 17 years down the track, I received an approval to go there for
to immigrate.
So we went over there and
To have a look,
mm-hmm. try.
Where, yeah. What part of the States?
Chicago.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
So. That's a big city.
Yeah, it is a big city.
Not much acreage around.
No. Oh, there's plenty of acreage. But...
Plenty.
Is there?
Mm. But I don't like the climate very much.
Oh, I see.
So, and it's a different environment for the children. The children love Australia very much.
Yes.
I love it there myself, but my children
the
and, the children.
They were, well, I mean, presumably they have friends and things that they formed here,
yeah,
and they're doing well.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, they love it here so much.
It's more peaceful, I reckon.
Being a midwife, is that that's something that you do in hospitals?
Yeah, I'm also a lactation consultant.
Yeah.
In a breastfeeding.
Yeah.
On breastfeeding, yeah.
And is that, how do you, that comes out of, that's a speciality out of nursing.
Yeah. Yeah.
And do you practice that as a, you know, as a business of your own, or do you work on staff?
I work at the hospital on a casual basis at the moment.
Mm-hmm.
I work in one of the public hospital for, you know, like 17 years.
Yes.
And I decided that, you know, I'll help my husband with his business for the time being and just work casual and start looking around for primary production.
Yes.
And if you can breastfeed your baby, why not?
Yes. Did you breastfeed yours?
Yep.
Yeah.
My two children, and they're happy.
They're happy. Do you have any beginnings of teenage problems or not yet?
I've got a few. It's part of it, you know.
But breastfeeding doesn't help that.
Nah.
Well, the thing is, at least they're healthy because they have to start off with, they're not, you know, they're only little babies, you know, but because they're being breastfed, they grew up nice and healthy and they haven't got a problem.
What are you a disciplinarian? Are you tough on them? Strict rules?
That's the problem.
I was raised in an authoritarian type discipline.
Yes.
But I have to,
hard to
change it a little bit or modify it a little bit.
That's a cultural difference.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah.
But it's not only a cultural difference because there are a lot of Australian parents who find that very difficult to deal with as well.
That's right.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah.
So what are the problems that are coming up? What do you think are the main problems that face your children? What
They're more independent, you see, so it's hard to, you know,
get
taught at school, you know, how to reason out, you know, how to, you know, express, you know, you tell them a little bit of words, you know, and they build it up, you know, they have to, you know, they don't agree, you know, they have to,
you
to push their, you know, their thinking, you know.
As I said, we live in an authoritarian type family. And he wouldn't even let him come to my place, you know, at that age. So we decided, well, we better get out of the country and get married. So
you eloped.
We eloped. So we eloped and came here.
And you rang your father from here and said, guess what?
No, actually, we were, both of us were, you know, like, his parents took him to the airport. My parents took him to, yeah, took yes. me to the airport.
Separately?
Separately. And didn't realize.
They didn't know that you were going to?
Together, no. Yeah. And then we just, you know, like, when I was, when we took, boarded a plane, that's when they realized, oh, my brother saw us. So he's got the idea then, but my parents was in the dark all the time.
So by the time the plane landed here,
no,
they
found out 6 months later.
6 months?
Yeah. I wouldn't dream of telling my dad.
Yes.
You know, gosh, he'll
yeah.
die.
Yeah.
So he thought, because I wasn't planning to stay here actually for mm-hmm. a long time.
Yes.
I only want to come here, get my, you know, registration,
yes.
come back and finish my master's in the Philippines, because I was doing my master's there.
You know, we didn't have any friends or, you know,
yeah.
relatives around here, you know.
Yeah.
There's not much Filipinos.
Did you speak English?
Yeah, we speak English.
Yeah. English is our second language.
Yes.
And Spanish is our third.
Yes.
So, well, you know, it wasn't very hard, but, you know, Australian English is really difficult at the beginning, you know, like, I was listening to that, you know, like, when they're talking in the hospital, and I thought they were speaking another language, you know, like I said, what language is that, what dialect, because in the Philippines, there's about 200 dialects. And I thought, well, that's another dialect, you know? Because, you know, everybody sounds different.
Yes.
You know, like you have the Scottish English and,
yes.
you know, Australian English. And I thought, gosh, what are they talking about, you know? And all these little idioms,
yes.
idiomatic expression. And I had a hard time catching up with that. So I really studied hard and, you know, read books and listen, you know, all the time. And so until I can get used to the language.
When did you tell your dad about having eloped and got married?
Yeah, well, I was already pregnant, and so uh-huh. he doesn't, you know.
What did he say?
He said, oh, well, your brother also did the same, he eloped too. My younger brother, who was only 16, eloped with his girlfriend. Because he was the one who saw us left,
yeah.
and he looks, at, you know, like he sort of emulate me, and then he realized, oh, my sister's, you know, eloping with him, I might as well elope with my girlfriend. So both of us were, you know. So my father had a shock, you know, he couldn't believe it. Because he always followed us wherever we go, you know, like
yeah.
when we go, he's there.
Yes.
And every time he comes around, you know, he will water the plants until the plants die, you know, because he's just watering and listening, you know. So that's how we live over there. And my letters doesn't get to me, you know. My dad usually opens it up and, you know, or throw it. You know, I'll find all my letters in the bin. You know, I never see them. You know, that's how strict my dad is. I even lock all my, you know, private letters and that, and he opens.
But you're not like that with your children.
Yeah, well, actually, my children is getting a very good deal. You know, like as I look at them, I said, no way, I wouldn't let my dad wouldn't let me do that. Because, you know, like my kids, you know, they come around with their girlfriend and they go straight to the bedroom. You know, I said, how could that be? Yeah. I told you, I wouldn't even dream of him coming to our place, you know.
Yeah.
It's so, you know, it's so free in here, you
yeah.
know, like the society is free. And in the Philippines, we are very conservative, you know. Because
yes.
I came from a very conservative background. And when I see these things happening, you know, I say, oh, no. So I have to get used to that. And, you know, now I'm sort of, you know, don't allow my ideas to interfere with my children's, you know, ideas. Because otherwise ours will clash so much.